No, thanks. Thanks, and good afternoon to the listeners, and thanks for having us. We think that this decision took long enough because upon her appointment in 2019, we said as the EFF, we don't have confidence in her in relation to the scandal that related to the disappearance of more than 300 million in the coffers of the state due to the funeral. So we have been calling for it and consistent in our decision that she is not fit for that position. She will make things worse for the province. So we have been calling for that. We've been consistent in relation to this case of the disappearance of the funds of Mandela funeral scandal.
And what do you believe should be the fate of those who are implicated along with her?
Well, I don't think it's about the face. It's about everyone who's implicated in corruption. Anyone else who's implicated must face the music. We don't have time for people who are looting resources that are meant to develop our people or any other issues that they are meant for. So it's not necessarily to ask about her as being the face. She is a MEC. She was appointed as an MEC. We said she must not be appointed, but the provincial leadership of the ANC continued. So it's not about her. It's about a principle which we'll all adhere to at all times.
Now, we believe that it's the PwC that advised the Premier to release her from the duties. What are your thoughts and your comments on that, on the fact that he was advised to do that?
Well, we said few weeks ago in a sitting of the legislature, the EFF, that the Premier, in terms of the Constitution, Section 132.2, she has got the power to appoint and remove MECs. That is what was supposed to happen. He didn't have to wait for a PwC to remind him of those powers that he has as a Premier. He should have acted. Anyway, the EFF has been saying that she was not supposed to have been appointed in the first place. So we said to him, go and invoke the Constitution. Look at the Constitution on the executive powers. It tells you what to do with someone who is behaving in this manner of this comrade office. So we do not even welcome the decision that was taken. It's something that we wanted for a very long time. It has traveled a long distance to get to where we are today in terms of the decision. It was supposed to have been long taken.
Do you believe that this is a decision that was to be taken by the Premier, or should it have been for the MEC, the former MEC, to herself step down after having been formally charged as per the regulations of her party?
I do not think she was going to do it. I really do not think she was going to do it out of her own volition. In terms of what their organization believes, that members who are formally charged to step aside, she should have done that. She didn't have to wait for the Premier to take this decision today. As soon as she went to court, she should have written a letter to the provincial leadership and said, I am resigning because of the resolutions that were taken by their own organization in their own conferences, which were not even part of. So she was supposed to resign on her own without being asked by anybody. We didn't want to see a Premier pronouncing her resignation, but it tells you that she was refusing. The fact that the Premier takes this decision, it means that her on her own, she could not do it. She still wanted to be part of the gravy train. She still wanted to be part of the blue lights. So she was still enjoying those things because the Department of Health is not doing anything, by the way, in this province. It has collapsed. So it's not like there was anything else she was doing except for blue lights and enjoying the free rides that she was enjoying.
I guess we'll leave it at that for this afternoon, sir. And actually, there were reports about 2 days ago where she said she will go only if the Premier tells her to go. And that seems to have been her fate indeed. Reaction there from the EFF's Yazini Tetyana. He's the Eastern Cape chairperson.